Hey everyone. New radars have been installed all around Dubai, while the Dubai police drones are almost up in action. The temperatures in Dubai have been soaring a little too high. The Emirates ID Authority will be making our lives a little bit easier, and stay tuned to hear about the new plans for the classic QE2 luxury ship. You're with me, Jessica, on The Roundabout. So, we've all been guilty of speeding every now and then, right? But perhaps you should reconsider speeding just over the limit, because the General Department of Traffic in Dubai has just announced that 24 new advanced speeding radars have been installed all around Dubai, which means that new bumps the entire number of radars around Dubai to about 538. Several radars have also been installed in Al Etihad Road, Sheikh Zayed Road, Al Khair Road, and Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Road. The new tower-like radars can detect drivers who drive behind yellow lines, those who jump red lights, video record violations, and they can even detect more than one vehicle at a time. So please be sure to be safe on the roads. So I remember a few weeks ago I told you about a remote controlled vehicle and drones from the Dubai police that would actually break up any riots if any occur? It's actually been unveiled. The designer of the two devices, Maher bin Haider of the emergency section of the Dubai police, will be operated by a smartphone which he believes is the first smartphone operated aircraft in the world. It'll keep an eye on any major events such as football matches, concerts and event openings, and it'll be able to view any potential riots before they actually happen, sending a police car to the scene. For now, the vehicle is armed with gas bombs which can reach an object from 500 meters away and can already reach about 80 kilometers per hour. What do you think about this? Is this cool or scary? Send us in your thoughts below or on Twitter at TheRoundabout2. Now, we all know how intense the heat can get in summer here. And if you've been feeling like it's just been a little bit too intense the last few days, that could just be because the temperatures have reached above 50 degrees Celsius in some parts of the country. It also doesn't seem to be cooling down anytime soon, with the National Center of Meteorology and Seismology suggesting that the daytime will remain very hot and hazy over the next few days. So anyone that's going out should take a great deal of care, even if you're just staying in the shade. To make our lives a little easier, the Emirates Identity Authority has announced that it plans to allow the Emirates ID card renewal through smartphones, as well as directly through their call centres within the next 2 months. The Director General of Emirates ID Authority, Dr. Mohammed Al-Khoury, has made an inspection visit to the Al Karama Centre in Dubai, and he met with a number of customers and actually listened to their thoughts and complaints with regards to the standard of services. With 55 registration centres around the country, serving around 27,000 customers daily, the smartphone renewal system will certainly save a lot of time. For those of you who didn't know, the last of the luxury liners, the Queen Elizabeth II or QE2, is moored and owned by Dubai. And what are the plans for this big luxury liner? No less than transforming it into an all-suite luxury floating hotel. Khamis Al-Buaymim, chairman of the Dry Docks World and Maritime World, stated that Dubai owns the QE2 and will never sell it. So, nearly 330 million dirhams will be spent on revamping the ship, which should be completed by 2014. The destination as to where it will be moored in the future is still kept as a secret, so looks like we'll just have to wait and see when the luxury liner will be back in action. That's all we have for you on this week's episode of The Roundabout. Don't forget to like us, subscribe, share this video, and follow us on Twitter at TheRoundabout2. For all of our friends celebrating Ramadan this season, we wish you a Ramadan Kareem. Here's your weather for the week. Have a lovely weekend.